Hello everyone, and welcome back to this Final Cut Pro tutorial. In today's video, we're going to learn to fine-tune and perfect your video edit by applying some speed effects. This is part 9 of my series. In parts 1 through 8, I built a rough cut, got some feedback on it, and used that feedback on my second pass. I'll link the videos in my description and in the top right corner. My video is really starting to come together, but there's still a few kinks to iron out. Before we get started, I would like to say thank you to all the people watching this series. As of this video, my channel just hit 100 subs. I know it's not that much, but to me it feels huge. I'd also like to thank everyone for the positive feedback in the comments. Makes me want to keep going. As always, if you enjoy these videos, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. 200 subs, here we come. First thing I'd like to go over today is retiming clips. Final Cut Pro makes it very easy to slow down your clips for some cool slow motion, speed up to get to the point sooner and make some cool time lapses, or even reverse your clips and play them backwards. First, I'll show you how to apply a constant speed change to a clip. In one of my first video clips, I'm going over a beautiful bridge. It takes a couple minutes to cross it, but watching for full 2 minutes is very boring, so I'll speed it up. In order not to mess up all the timings, I'll lift this clip out of my storyline, ripple trim out the whole clip, and click and drag it to the top layer of my project. Now, I'll trim off the parts before and after the bridge. With the clip selected, click on the timing menu button. Since I want to speed up my clip, I'll select fast and choose 2 times. A retime editor bar appears at the top of my clip, the clip plays 2 times faster, and the duration is cut in half. Let's review the clip to see how it looks. It's better, but it's still taking up too much time. I'll click on the timing menu button again and select custom. Here you can manually enter the rate of playback or a duration you want your clip to be. Let's try 300% and see how it looks. Getting better. Another way you can change the speed of your clip is by clicking and dragging the retime editor handle at the edge of your clip. I'll zoom in on my timeline for more precision and set the playhead at the end of the gap clip created when I lifted my clip from the timeline. Now, I'll click and drag the retime handle towards the playhead. A retime editor bar shows me the rate of playback for my clip. I'll drag this clip back down into my timeline and get rid of the gap clip. I'll zoom out and review my project. Much better. Now, let's try slow motion. I'll select a clip I would like to slow down, and instead of using the timing menu button, I'll use a keyboard shortcut Command R. A retime editor bar shows up on top of my clip where I can select a few speed options. I'll click on the drop-down menu, choose slow and 50%. My clip is slowed down and plays back at half the speed. It looks a little choppy, but that's because of the frame rate this video was recorded at. I'll make a video in the future discussing frame rate options and how to get silky smooth slow motion playback, but for now, this will work just fine. So that was a constant speed change that's applied to a full clip. Final Cut Pro has another retiming effect, the variable speed change, which applies at least 2 different playback rates within a single clip. Let's try it out. I'll select one of my clips towards the end of the project. I want the start of it to play back at normal speed, but then speed up the second half. Since it will play back faster, I can use more footage of this clip. Like I showed you before, I can click and drag the endpoint of this clip to make it longer, but there's another way to do it. With the clip selected, press Ctrl D. The clip's duration is displayed in the dashboard. Let's make this clip about 20 seconds long. I'll enter 20, period, and hit enter. Final Cut Pro extends my clip so it's exactly 20 seconds long. I'll cue the playhead about halfway through my clip where I want to speed it up. With the clip selected, press the timing menu button and select blade speed. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Shift B. The clip's retime editor bar opens up, indicating the 2 speed segments I created. I'll select fast and 4 times for a second segment. Instead of just abruptly changing playback speed, Final Cut Pro inserts a speed transition between the clips where the playback slowly ramps up. You can adjust the timing of the speed transition by clicking and dragging the transition edges. Let's see how that looks. If, after reviewing the edit, you decide that you played it at the wrong point, you can still adjust it. Double-click the junction between the 2 segments and a speed transition menu box opens up. Here, you can deselect both sides of the transition if you don't like it. I like the way it looks, so I'll leave this box checked. Now, I'll click the source frame edit button. The source frame editor appears as a film frame icon. This is where you can pick the exact frame where your transition takes place. I'll click and drag the source frame icon to the right until a frame where I want the speed change to happen, just as I go by the road sign. I'll double click the source frame icon to close the editor. You can blade speed your clip as many times as necessary at different points. Let's go back and look at the first riding clip in my project. Notice the black bars on each side of the screen? I shot most of my clips on a GoPro camera, and if you ever used one before, you know most of them don't have viewfinders to frame your shot. Even for the ones that do have one, if the camera is mounted to your helmet, it's kind of hard to get the framing perfect. That's why I set it to 1440p resolution. It gives me a taller 4x3 picture, and when editing, I can crop it down to 16x9, pick the best frame, and still have full 1080 resolution. I can also stretch it if I need to keep everything in my frame. So, let's crop it down and fill the screen. I'll place my playhead over the clip and select it. Now, click on the Transform menu button and select Crop. When I choose the crop option, a 16x9 frame that will fill today's TV screens is highlighted. I can click and drag it to select the frame I want to keep. The yellow line in the middle helps keep your clip centered. If you drag the clip to the side, it disappears, and when you return to the middle, the yellow line returns. It only acts as a guide, and you can still choose whatever part of the frame you like. Once I pick the part of the frame I want to use, I'll click Done. Final Cut Pro crops the top and bottom parts of my picture and zooms in to fill the frame. If your footage is a lower resolution, zooming in like this might make it appear a little blocky. I'll make a video and explain video resolutions once the series is done. I'm going to go through my video and crop all the clips that have black bars in them. You can do this earlier on in the project, but I like to leave it to near the end when I have settled on which clips I use in my video. Next week, I'm going to add a few video effects to my clips to make them look a little more artistic. If you haven't yet, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Post any questions you may have in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. Also, if you see a question or a problem someone else has in the comments and you have the solution, feel free to answer it. We can all learn some from each other. And if you have a better or more efficient way to edit or any other tips and tricks, let me know. Just like you guys, I'm always trying to improve. I'm looking forward to reading your comments, so don't be shy. And I hope you come back next week.